Good morning and good afternoon to all of you. Welcome to my class. Today's topic is photoelectric effects. So understand you are seeing the definition, photoelectric effects. And this is the metal surface. From the metal surface, onto the metal surface, when sufficient frequency of light, this is the sufficient frequency of light. When the sufficient frequency of light is striking onto the metal surface, from the surface of the metal, removal of electrons, nothing but ejection of electrons is going to take place. So when the light is going to strike the metal surface, ejection of electrons is going to take place. The ejected electrons are going to move. Moving electrons can cause to producing of electricity. Once again, moving electrons can cause to producing of electricity. So when the metal surface is going to strike with a sufficient frequency of radiation, due to ejection of electrons, electricity is going to be produced. This phenomena is called as photoelectric effect. Yes, of course, if you see this point, suppose at this point on the surface of the metal, if an electron is there at this point on the surface of the metal, and that electron is holded with the surface of the metal with some energy. So to remove the outermost electron from the surface of the metal, some minimum amount of energy is required. Once again, the minimum amount of energy is required. See this one. The minimum amount of energy is required to remove the electrons from the surface of the metal. That minimum amount of energy is called as threshold energy. Threshold energy is indicated with E naught. Yes, I'm going to increase the screen. Yes, sorry. So threshold energy is the minimum amount of energy required to remove the electrons from the surface of the metal is called as threshold energy. The symbol of threshold energy is E naught. E naught. My dear students, all of you know, work is a form of energy. Once again, work is a form of energy. So instead of writing capital E naught, we can also use W naught. The symbol of work is W. So instead of writing E naught, we can also write W naught to indicate threshold energy. If you are using E naught, W naught indicates work function. Once again, W naught indicates work function. So either it is the work function or it is the threshold energy, that is the minimum amount of energy required to eject an electron from the surface of the metal. And to eject an electron from the surface of the metal, what is required? The minimum frequency of radiation is required. That minimum frequency of radiation required to eject an electron from the surface of the metal is called as threshold frequency. Threshold frequency is indicated with nu naught. Nu naught. This is a symbol, nu naught. So nu naught is called as threshold frequency, means the minimum amount of frequency of radiation required to eject the electrons from the surface of the metal. If you understand these two concepts, then we will go through the total concept. So here we are knowing about two terms. One is threshold energy. Second one is threshold frequency, right? Did you understand the two points, threshold energy and the threshold frequency? Did you understand the two points? Then we will move to the next point. Yes, very good. Okay. So now coming to the point, already we know the formula. We know the formula, photoelectric effect mathematically represented as capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. Here capital E means, what is capital E here? Capital E is the amount of energy striking onto the surface of the metal. Once again, the amount of energy striking onto the surface of the metal. And E naught is called as threshold energy of the electrons of the metal, or simply threshold energy of the metal. And KE is called as kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. Once again, KE is called as kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. So from this formula, By using this formula, capital E is equal to E naught plus KE, we are going to modify the formula. We are going to modify the formula. First, the formula, initial formula is capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. And according to photoelectric effect, according to Planck's quantum theory, capital E is equal to H nu. So in this formula, this is the formula representing photoelectric effect. In this formula, I am going to substitute H nu. Then instead of capital E, I can write H nu. And instead of E naught, I can write H nu naught, because we know E is equal to H nu. Capital E is equal to H nu. So E naught is equal to H nu naught. Here nu naught stands for threshold frequency. Once again, nu naught stands for threshold frequency. That is the minimum amount of frequency required to eject the electrons from the surface of the metal is called as threshold frequency, indicated by nu naught. So E naught is equal to H nu naught. Capital E is equal to H nu plus S. And again, we are taking KE. So this is the modified formula of photoelectric effects by using Planck's quantum theory. This is the modified form of photoelectric effect by using Planck's quantum theory. The formula is H nu is equal to H nu naught plus KE. Now, I want to calculate the kinetic energy of ejected electrons. To calculate the kinetic energy of ejected electrons, then what we can write? H nu minus H nu naught. Very important formula. With the help of this formula, we are going to do some problems. So once again, KE means kinetic energy of ejected electrons, that is equal to H nu minus H nu naught. My dear students, here H is common, here H is common. So simply we can take the H as common, then we can write the formula KE is equal to H of nu minus H of nu minus nu naught. This is a formula, important formula you have to remember. Kinetic energy of ejected electrons is equal to H into nu minus nu naught. All of you know, what is small h? Text me your answer. What is small h? What is its value? Text me your answer. What is small h and what is its value? Waiting for your response. What is small h in this formula? Yes, what is small h in this formula? Planck's constant. Very good. What is the value of Planck's constant? What is the value of Planck's constant? 6.6256. Here I am writing the value. H value 6.6256 into, you have to remember this value. We will use this value so many number of times. Planck's constant value, H is equal to 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. If you are using the units joules, then the 10 power value is minus 34. Suppose if the unit is given in the ergs, then H is equal to Planck's constant, H is equal to 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 27. 10 to the power of minus 27. Once again, 10 to the power of minus 27 ergs second. So you have to remember these two values. So finally, once again, KE means kinetic energy of ejected electrons from the surface of the metal, is equal to H into nu minus nu naught. Okay. Suppose If I am not going to use this formula, suppose if I am going to take the formula, same, h nu is equal to h nu naught plus ke. Ke means kinetic energy. Yes, all of you know the physics. In the physics, what is the formula of kinetic energy? Mostly you will use the formula, kinetic energy formula, in the physics most of the times. Ke, I am not asking about PE. You are saying the PE. PE means potential energy. MGH means that is the potential energy. I am asking about kinetic energy, not about potential energy. Kinetic energy formula, Ke is equal to, here I am writing. Kinetic energy formula, Ke is equal to, remember this formula. Kinetic energy Ke is equal to half mv square. So instead of Ke, here I am going to take half mv square. So these are the different forms of photoelectric effect with the help of Planck's quantum theory. Now the formula is h nu is equal to h nu naught plus half mv square. Yes. Now you will get a doubt. Sir, I know nu is the sufficient frequency of light striking on the surface of the metal. And nu naught is the, what is nu naught? Threshold frequency of the metal. Of course. What is meant by m? m is the mass of the electron. Here, small m represents mass of the electron. V represents velocity of the ejected electrons. Once again, V represents velocity of the ejected electrons. Now I am writing the formula once again. H nu naught plus half mv square. This is the derived formula, not the original formula. It is the derived formula. H nu is equal to h nu naught plus half mv square. Then I can write half mv square is equal to, that is the kinetic energy of the ejected electron. Half mv square is equal to h of nu minus nu naught. Now I want to calculate velocity of ejected electron. Because all of you know mass of the electron is constant. Once again, small m indicates mass of the electron. The mass of the electron is constant. What is the value of the mass of the electron? Can anybody remember the mass of the electron? 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kgs. Once again, 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kgs is the mass of the electron. My dear students, to know about the mass of the electron, charge of the electron, all these values are called as fundamental values of the fundamental particles. All these are given in the starting of the chapter in the atomic structure or structure of atom. Once you go to the textbook. Anyway, I want to calculate a V. V means velocity of electron. To calculate the V, first I am taking V square. V square is equal to H of nu minus nu naught. It is in the denominator part. Now here, that will be in the numerator part. And m in the numerator part, now it comes to denominator part. So I calculated the V square. Square of velocity of electron. Once again, square of velocity of electron is equal to 2H into nu minus nu naught by m. Then velocity of electron, V is equal to, yes, all of you know, V is equal to square root of 2H into nu minus nu naught by small m. So this is the final formula to calculate the velocity of ejected electrons from the surface of the metal. My dear students, all these formulas will be used in CET, NEET and JEE. But for the PU level, no need to remember all these formulas. Just they ask about what is photoelectric effect, How can you explain? Just you have to write the statement and you have to write the derived formulas. Already I provide them with the notes. Just remember these formulas. They are very helpful in the calculation of CET and NEET bits. Once again, V stands for velocity of electron, that is equal to square root of 2h into nu minus nu naught by m. Small m means mass of the electron. Okay? So photoelectric effect. From the photoelectric effect, what we can understand? From the photoelectric effect, what we can understand? When the surface of a metal is going to strike with a sufficient frequency of radiation from the metal surface, ejection of electrons are going to happen. That ejected electrons are going to produce electricity. That means light is going to be converted into electricity. Of course, you will get a doubt. Sir, most of the periodic table is containing metals. S block elements are metals. D block elements are metals. F block elements are metals. Whereas P block contains metals, non-metals, as well as metalloids. So that is about classification of elements that will be studied in the second chapter, in the third chapter. That is the periodic classification of elements. So anyway, we are having so many elements, 118 elements are there. Among them, most of the elements are metals. Now you will get a doubt. Sir, which type of metals are going to exhibit photoelectric effects? Did you get the doubt or not? Did you get this doubt or not? Which type of metals? My dear students, the internet is not stable. Maybe the connection will go off. I don't know. If it is continued, it will be good. The internet connection is not stable here. Yes, once again, my question. Whether you get the doubt or not, which type of metals are going to exhibit photoelectric effect? Yes, S block elements are only going to exhibit photoelectric effects. Once again, the S block elements are only going to exhibit photoelectric effect. Coming to the S block elements, what are the S block elements? Sorry, now among the S block elements, only first year group elements. S block elements are classified into two groups, that is the first year group elements and second year group elements. First year group elements are called as alkali metals. Second year group elements are called as alkaline earth metals. The second year group elements are called as alkaline earth metals. So when we come to the S block elements, second year group elements are not exhibiting, only the first year group elements are exhibiting the photoelectric effect. And the first year group elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Wait a minute. Yes, now you can see. So the first year group elements, which are known as alkali metals, the elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Of course, francium is also there, but the francium is radioactive. So I'm going to consider all these elements. For your convenient, I'm going to share the screen. That is the different types of first year group elements. Now on the screen, you can see easily. First A group elements, just a minute. First A group elements, yes. Now you can see the first A group elements. On the screen you are able to see. So the first A group elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. And they are present in the group. Group means from top to bottom. Once again, group means from top to bottom. So whenever the elements are present in a group, from top to bottom, the atomic size is going to get increased. Once again, the atomic size of the elements in a group from top to bottom is going to increase. So among the first year group elements, lithium to cesium, CS means cesium, which is going to have large size? Which one is going to have large size? Text me your answer. Which one is going to have large size? Okay, my dear students, whether the video is clear or not, first text me the answer, whether the video is clear or not. Whether the video is clear or not. Wait, please. Whether the video is coming clearly or not. It's lagging, sir. Okay, anyhow, I'm going to record the session. I will send, no need to worry. Anyhow, once again, the Fassier group elements. The Fassier group elements are lithium 2, cesium, which is having the large size. Cesium is going to have the large size. And if I say this one, this point, what this point indicates? That is the nucleus. Center of the atom is called as nucleus. Once again, the center of the atom is called as nucleus. From the nucleus to outermost orbit. This is the outermost orbit. Once again, this is the nucleus and this one is the outermost orbit. From the nucleus to outermost orbit, if the distance increases, the attraction of the nucleus, is going to have less effectiveness on the valency electrons. The outermost electrons are called as valency electrons. So, in the case of cesium, the outermost electron, that is the electrons present on the surface, can be easily removed. Once again, because of the large size of cesium atom, the nucleus is having less attraction on the valency electrons. So, from the surface of the cesium metal, we can easily remove the electron. So, which type of energy is required? Whether more amount of energy is required or less amount of energy is required to remove the electron from the surface of the cesium metal, Yes, video is trucking. Whether more amount of energy is required or less amount of energy is required. Less amount of energy is required. Means the threshold frequency and the threshold energy of the cesium is very, very less. Once again, the threshold energy or the threshold frequency of the cesium is very, very less. So if any metal is having less threshold frequency and threshold energies, such metals can easily exhibiting photoelectric effects. To understand this concept, I'm going to show some values. On the screen, you can see some values. Yes, table 2.2, values of work function for few metals. Here the metals given are lithium, sodium, potassium, magnesium, copper, and silver. Ag means silver. Once again, Li means lithium, Na is the sodium, K means potassium, Mg means magnesium, Co means copper, Ag means silver. So all these are the metals. All of you know all these are the metals. And for these metals, what was given? W naught is given. W naught. What is meant by W naught? W naught means work function. Once again, W naught means work function or threshold energy. Threshold energy, whether it may be W naught or it may be E naught. So threshold energy of lithium 2.42, threshold energy of sodium 2.3, threshold energy of potassium 2.25, threshold energy of magnesium 3.7, threshold energy of copper 4.8, threshold energy of silver, Ag means silver, threshold energy of silver is 4.3. Yes, now you can guess among these metals, which one is going to easily exhibit photoelectric effect? To exhibit the photoelectric effect, the metal should easily lose the electron. Once again, to exhibit the photoelectric effect, the metal should easily lose the electron. To remove the electron easily, minimum amount of energy is required. That is called as threshold energy. The threshold energy should be minimum. The metal with less threshold energy can easily exhibit photoelectric effect. Once again, my statement, the metal with less threshold energy or less work function can easily exhibit photoelectric effect. So according to the given table and given values, which metal is going to have less threshold energy or less work function? Potassium is having less work function. Once again, potassium is having less work function, 2.25. So among the lithium, sodium, potassium, magnesium, copper and silver, which one is the best metal to exhibit the photoelectric effect? Means potassium. So from this table you can understand that the metal with less work function can easily exhibit photoelectric effects. Yes, you will get a doubt again. You will get a doubt. Suppose if you are coming to first year group elements, the first year group elements are called as alkali metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Down the group, the atomic size increases. Once again, from lithium to cesium, down the group, the atomic size increases. When the atomic size increases, the tendency to lose the electrons increases. Once again, as the atomic size increases, the tendency to lose the electrons increases. Means, for the cesium, less energy is enough for the cesium to remove the electron. So cesium is going to have less E naught value, whereas lithium is going to have more E naught value. E naught value, otherwise we can say W naught value. W naught means work function, E naught means threshold energy. We can use any word. So simply you can understand that lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, down the group as the atomic size increases, the work function values of the metals get decreases. Such metals with less work function are readily participating in photoelectric effects. So finally we can understand that among the alkali metals, which is readily exhibiting photoelectric effects? Among the alkali metals, which one is readily exhibiting photoelectric effects? Text me your answer. Among the alkali metals, which one is readily exhibiting photoelectric effect? Yes, correct. Cesium. Cesium is correct. But the availability is called as occurrence. The availability is called as occurrence. Among all these metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, more occurring metal is potassium. So that's why in making of photoelectric cells we are using potassium. But cesium is the best metal to make of photovoltaic cells or photoelectric cells. Photovoltaic or photoelectric means a cell or a device which converts light into electricity. Once again, a cell or a device which converts light into electricity, such cells or devices are called as photovoltaic cells or photoelectric cells. So the photoelectric cells are depending upon the principle photoelectric effects. So finally, what you understood from photoelectric effect means whether only the first year group metals are expecting photoelectric effects, whether only the first year group elements are expecting the photoelectric effect, any type of metal can expect photoelectric effects. Once again, any type of metal can expect photoelectric effect, but to eject the electron from the surface of the metal, minimum frequency of radiation must strike on the surface of the metal. Then only such metals are going to exhibit photoelectric effect. Yes, the time is very less. Still the topic is there. Next class, tomorrow we will discuss the remaining topic. If you understood, please text me whether it is understood or not. Text me fast. Still some topic is there, a little bit topic is there about this one. In the next class tomorrow, we'll discuss. If it is understood, please text me in the chat box. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day. Text me in the chat box. Yes, remaining students, please respond whether the class is understood or not. And please read the PDF. I send the PDF. Please read the PDF to understand more, to understand better. Please read the PDF. If you are having the doubt, please watch the recorded video till the end. Still the session is getting continued. I don't know why. Today the session is still continued, but tomorrow I will discuss the remaining topic. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day. Of course, my dear students, the meeting remaining 3 minutes. Wait. Okay, fine. And one more point here is, the main point here in the photoelectric effect is, as you can see now, just a minute. Okay, anyhow, the time is less, my dear students. No need to hurry. Tomorrow we'll discuss. That is about velocity of ejected electrons. The velocity of ejected electrons from the surface of the metal, on which factor they are going to get dependent. And the number of ejected electrons from the surface of the metal, on which factor they are going to depend. So these two will be discussed in the next class. And regarding this photoelectric effect, we will solve two problems that was given in the NCERT textbook. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day.